instead of being essentially motivated by image, that was humiliated me before, it was motivated by language and the sound of speech. I think Jean-Pierre is a filmmaker of sound. And I want to thank him for it, because he taught me a lot. He's the being a top man for the day. So it's only fine. And Jean-Pierre.
So, I thought about framing it with quotation, the backdrop of French education. So the first one I thought about was the last letter of Valmont to Madame de Tourvel, the one after which she goes berserk. And it goes, "I took you with pleasure, I leave you without regret, such is life." Then I got confused in case that you would guys see yourself as Valmont and me as Madame de Tourvel. And at the same time, I thought that the DNA, the puritanical streak of this part of the world would prevent that. So, I'm glad you mentioned Manny, because Manny is the reason why I'm here. I was so fresh off the boat that I thought all Americans were like Manny. It immediately garnered me some serious hatred on the part of many people, but at that point the pleat was done and I followed. And then you become here, you fall into this sunny variant of the Stockholm syndrome, Laoya syndrome. You start liking everything. The incontrollably florid emails from the cheerleader, the faculty meeting in which commonplace is always groundbreaking. And those faculty meetings were on a Friday morning make a good night at the Borgia feel like high tea at the Dorchester. But, and it's the last words of Madame Mao at her trial. It is time to empty the stage. Remember, you will always come across me in the books about China. Don't be surprised to see my name smeared. There's nothing more they can do to me. And don't forget that I was an actress, a great actress. I acted with passion. For those who were fascinated by me, you owe me applause. And for those who were disgusted, you may spit. Thank you all for coming.